Introduction to Ones and Tens.
Hello friends, I am the parrot. Welcome to this lesson. Come, let's see what you will learn in this lesson. What are ones and tens? And how to write numbers in the form of ones and tens? Chotu and his mother went to the market today to get vegetables. On returning home, Chotu's mother kept all vegetables except onions in the fridge. All onions are kept on the table.
Mummy, you asked the vegetable vendor to give 1 kg onions. How many onions did you get?
Can you count and tell me how many onions did we buy?
Yes, Mummy, I will tell you now.
Wait, count the number of onions by making a bundle of 10 each. For this, first make 1 bundle of 10 onions.
Okay, Mummy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Take this, Mother. This is a bundle of 10 onions.
Very good, Chotu. Now, how many more onions are there?
There is 1 more onion, Mummy.
So, this is 1 bundle of 10 onions, which has 10 onions. And this is 1 more onion. So, in total, how many onions do we have, Chotu?
10 and 1. That means we have 11 onions, isn't it, Mummy?
Yes, Chotu. Do you know that how else can we write 11?
No, Mummy. How do we write it?
Come on, let me explain it to you. When we make a group of 10 things, then this group is called tens. And the open things are called ones. So by that, we mean 10 means a group of 10 and ones means 1, that is open things. And when there are 10 ones, then they make 1 tens. Okay, Chotu, tell me something. Can 9 onions together make 1 tens?
No, Mummy. For this, we will need 1 more onion. This will be 9 ones.
Absolutely right, Chotu. This means that 10 onions or 10 balls, all those things present in a group of 10 makes tens because they are in a group of 10. But 4, 8 and 9 things which are less than 10, they are ones and we count them individually. Have you understood?
Yes, Mummy.
So now can you tell me how many tens and ones are there in 11 onions?
There would be 1 tens and 1 ones in 11 onions, isn't it, Mummy?
Yes, Chotu, you are absolutely right.
So, children, do you know that when we write numbers in ones and tens, then we call them as place value of the numbers? For example, if I have 15 balls with me, then in this 15, the place value of 5 is 5 ones, which means 5 balls, and the place value of 1 is 10, which means 10 balls. So the total is 15 balls. So children, that's all for today. In this video, we learned what are tens and ones and how to write numbers in the form of tens and ones. In the next video, we will look at some more interesting examples of tens and ones. Till then, my friends!